Bockwinkle grabs the Giants' hair. Bockwinkle pounds on the face of the Giant and now pulls back on the chin. Bockwinkle with a rear headlock on Andre the Giant. And now trying to switch into that version of the sleeper, which helped to wear down the Giant earlier. Bockwinkle flexing out that leg that was caught in the ankle scissors of Andre the Giant. The Giant trying to get to his feet if he can do that. A lot of the effectiveness of the sleeper will be cut away. The Giant coming up, Bockwinkle on his back. Andre leans backward and Bockwinkle is squashed into the corner. It's been a grueling battle for the world heavyweight title here at the Winnipeg Arena. This is Larry Madison at ringside. A grueling match between the title holder, Nick Bockwinkle, the challenger, Andre the Giant. A big chop from the Giant to Nick Bockwinkle. Another blast from Andre the Giant. Axe Hennig, the special referee, keeping an eye on things, but those blows from Andre were very much legal. Andre reeling from the effects of the sleeper that Bockwinkle's been applying repeatedly, although not constantly, because Andre's been able to break out at times, but Bockwinkle has concentrated on that sleeper and an attack to the lower back and the spine of Andre for the past 5 or 6 minutes. Andre ties up the neck of Bockwinkle in the ropes. The world champion being strangled with the ropes by Andre the Giant. Luckily for Bockwinkle, he manages to get the head out. Andre has, oh my goodness, what a slash by the Giant, and Andre does indeed have things going his way now. Bockwinkle whipped to the ropes, high up over the top, from 8 foot in the air, Bockwinkle sent crashing down by Andre the Giant. The Giant, another blast, and Bockwinkle sags into the ropes. Bockwinkle yanked away from the ropes by the Giant and hurled across the ring and into the corner. The Giant charges in and misses. Oh! The Giant trying to catch Bockwinkle with that flying tackle, instead hit the buckle, and I think his head hit the coupler between the turnbuckle and the ring post. That's steel. No man's head, no matter how big he is, can withstand a shot like that without some sort of damage. Heenan's hanging on to the Giant's leg from outside the ring. Heenan hanging on to the Giant so Bockwinkle can flail away on him. Axe Hennig trying to pull Bockwinkle off. He grabs Bockwinkle and gives him a slash across the ring into the corner. The Giant kicked Heenan. Oh, Bockwinkle comes up and punches Larry Hennig. And he's calling for the bell.
Out here.
Here comes Bobby Heenan. Bobby Heenan's family, Ken Patera and Bobby Duncombe, they throw a chair in the ring. Hennig on his own. Patera, Duncombe, who feel ever robbed over tonight against Heenan, against Hennig when he's a referee. Oh, Duncombe has brass knuckles. Duncombe with a pair of brass knuckles, and they're triple teaming. Larry the Axe, Hennig, Patera, Bockwinkle, and Duncombe battering Larry the Axe. Hennig being pounded on by the entire Heenan family. Here comes the Giant back. The Giant realizing what has happened. Andre the Giant, Patera catches him with a kick. We have a Donnybrook. The Giant clearing the ring. Patera's gone. Duncombe's gone. Bockwinkle hit with a headbutt. And Andre the Giant clears the deck, fires a chair at Bockwinkle. Axe Hennig battered by a vicious, ruthless assault from the Heenan family. After he called for the bell, I'm sure to disqualify Nick Bockwinkle. That means that Bockwinkle's going to keep the title, even though Andre the Giant will be the winner. You can see Larry the Axe Hennig bleeding from that attack A vicious assault typical of the Heenan family. Andre the winner, but by disqualification to the belt, stays with Bachwinkle.